Hi, my name is Uma Achra. I am from Maharashtra, India. I am here to tell you about my journey from Maharashtra to Canada. My route was India to Serbia and from Serbia to Canada. So I booked Qatar Airways from India till Serbia. So my route with Qatar Airways was India to Doha, Doha to Istanbul, and Istanbul to Serbia. And I booked KLM from Serbia to Toronto, which had a layover of 1 hour at Amsterdam. So when we are boarding flight from India, we are provided with two boarding pass. One is from Mumbai, like I traveled from Mumbai, so it is Mumbai to Doha and Doha to Istanbul. We are instructed to collect our third boarding pass at Istanbul, and getting that boarding pass is not an easy task. I was denied to board my flight at Istanbul, and I was asked to, I had two options. I can either purchase a ticket with their airlines, that is Turkish Airlines, and travel to Serbia, else I was asked to leave and move towards my country. Like, I had these two options. So I went with Turkish Airlines. I booked a ticket on spot with Turkish Airlines, and I took a flight to Serbia, which was not simple at that point. I was even drilled with Turkish Airlines. Like, I was the last person to board the flight. I was asked about my student visa. I was asked about many things. They took a photo of my all documents. They took a photo of me. They were speaking in their language, and their expressions said that their expressions were as if I was a terrorist. That is how they were looking at me, and they were talking something about me. So after a lot of struggles, I was somehow they were convinced with my documents, and then I was allowed to board the flight. The things did not end over here. As I took a different airlines, which was Turkish Airlines, my luggage was stuck at Turkey. So and I was asked to raise a form when I reach Serbia, and I would get my luggage in next few days. After landing in Serbia, I went to the counter, luggage missing counter, and I submitted a form. They told this I was the 10th person in last 5 days who went through all such things, and they say they'll be transferring luggage in next few days, but it takes approximately 8 to 10 days. So that's a big problem. I had some contacts, so I was lucky enough to get my luggage within 2 days. But I have seen people who got their luggage in 7 or 8 days, or maybe more than that. So the journey from Serbia to Canada was smooth. The only issue was there was a layover of 1 hour at Amsterdam, but the flight was delayed by half hour, so we had to run to board our flight. So make sure you have at least 2 hours layover at any stop that you have in between your final destination in the country that you are starting from. Regarding Istanbul, I would suggest not to take this route. As I was denied to board my flight, they didn't give me, I asked them why did they do this to me, but they didn't have any reason. They never provide you proper reason for their behavior, and it was not just me. I could see there approximately 4 to 6 people who were waiting. I was lucky enough, I had my passport and my ticket with me, but they had snatched their passports, their boarding passes and tickets, and they were actually waiting there. So the drawback of taking that route is, like, on every other airport you'll find free Wi-Fi, but in Turkey you have to you are allowed to take you are allowed to use Wi-Fi only for an hour. That too on basis of your passport number. You have to scan your passport. You will get access for access to free Wi-Fi for an hour. And post that you have to pay them some amount for each hour you are using their Wi-Fi. So if they snatch your passport, you do not have access to Wi-Fi. You cannot get anything. And if you are stuck there, you are completely blocked, I would say. There was this girl from South Africa. They had the people at Turkey, like at Istanbul airport, had snatched her passport, her boarding pass, her ticket, and she was there from last 13 hours. She wasn't provided with food, water or internet. She was not able to connect with her family or anyone around. She was not even able to connect with embassy, and there was no one to help her. She was crying there and she was asking for help, but people in Istanbul are not really very helpful, so no one came forward to help her. So that is the case. Handling such situation is not always easy, so be careful with that route. I would suggest please don't take that route. Regarding the cost, as I had student membership with Qatar Airways, it cost me around 60,000 from India to Serbia, and 40,000 from Serbia to Canada. These are the flight tickets, and 9,000 dinars at Serbia. Like, that is approximately 6,500 to 7,000 INR for a PCR test, and you can definitely stay at any place. Like, the hotel rate fare for per night starts from 2,000 to something around 25,000 to 30,000 per night. So whatever is affordable for you, you can say. So overall cost would be around 1.3 to 1.4 lakhs, including your stay, including your meals. And well, there's one more thing that everyone should consider is, if you are traveling to Serbia, there is this weight concept. Like, if there are two different concepts, one is weight concept, one is peace concept. So if you're traveling to Serbia, you need to consider weight, how much amount of weight you are carrying, because you will be cost according to the weight and not according to the pieces that you are carrying. So even if you carry an 1 kg extra, you'll have to pay accordingly. If you're traveling to Canada, it's a peace concept, so you are charged according to the piece that you are carrying and not according to the weight that you are carrying. Like, weight is one factor, but peace is what is more considered or is more highlighted over here. So if you are traveling to Serbia, make sure you have enough, like, sufficient the weight that is allowed. You are carrying that much amount of weight only, else you will be charged as according to the weight and not peace. That's all. Thank you. If you have any questions, let me know.